My name is Dr. Alan Lim. I'm the founder at Scratch Labs. We opened up our doors in 2012. That's been 8 years now. Yeah, you know, I'm up here in Park City with the Bowerman track team and Gwen. It's really interesting coming into a camp environment. Obviously, we are at higher elevation and altitude. That's one of the reasons athletes love coming here, but I think that the real benefit is that camp environment, that really focused environment where you can do a lot of hard work with your teammates, where there's that natural competitive spirit and where you're pushing yourself to another level. That increase in training load and the consistency of that, being also in an environment where you can recover and you're not distracted by life, that's what it takes for athletes to come up to the next level.
The cadence is a lot different at altitude. It's solely about training. So, you know, every day it's literally just, you know, I think we see this a lot or hear this a lot, it's like eat, sleep, train, repeat. And for me, that's exactly what it is at altitude. I wake up in the morning, I eat, I go to train, I eat, I come home, I rest, I train again, eat again. And it's just, the cadence is almost slowed down. We don't have any outside distractions. I think that's a big thing about training camp, and the sole focus is on recovering and hitting those workouts hard.
Not only does she manage her training so well, but she also manages all of the little things. Her sleep, napping, recovery, the strength work, flexibility, you know, along with Pat, getting all the food prepared and ready to go so that she's on an incredibly consistent schedule with respect to taking care of herself. Because ultimately, it's not just how hard you train that causes the adaptation, it's how you recover after that training where the adaptation actually comes. That being said, there's a saying in sport, fields may be born, but winners are made. Meaning that if you've got an Olympic race and you've got all these athletes coming to the start line, every single one of them was born to be there. But the person who wins that day, that person is going to be made. That is a true meritocracy, right? And so ultimately it comes down to how hard are you willing to work? How disciplined are you? How committed are you to that daily grind?
I think it's really important to start your hydration and fueling training the same time that you start your training for the actual race. So when I started marathon training, as soon as my marathon workout started, that's when I started experimenting with the hydration.
Not every day needs to be a hard day of training. Over the course of a week, you're really looking at two or three really, really quality workouts, which gives you time in between to prepare for those hard days by making sure that you've got your groceries, you're doing your chores, you're getting your food prepared, you're doing the dishes, you're keeping your environment exactly the way it needs to be. And so I think what people don't really understand about a training camp or a training environment is how many little things you need to do to take care of yourself, take care of your life. And if you attend to those chores, especially on your rest days and your off days, and set yourself up so that on those hard days, everything happens automatically, whether it's breakfast to having food, you know, right when you begin your workout, or you can continue to stay hydrated and fueled during that workout, to the recovery food that you get right after, to making sure that dinner happens at a good time, you can clean up, go to bed, and rest. Those are the things that really make the difference between good and great.
When I switched over from the marathon to the track, it's been very interesting for me, because when I used to do track, I didn't think about nutrition at all. And with the marathon, I was forced to think about nutrition. And I just noticed that when I was fueling through my workouts, I recovered so much better and faster. And I was able to, I just felt stronger, more recovered. I could sleep better. I wasn't eating as much at night because I was fueling throughout the day properly. And so for me, when I went back to track training, I continued to use what I learned in marathon training of how to fuel pre-workouts, how to fuel during and after. And it's really made a huge improvement, I think, in my health, staying healthy, and as well just being able to recover and be able to come back to that next workout a few days later and hit it hard.
That little change of not having to wait an extra hour or two to eat and to fuel made a huge difference in how I was recovering. To eliminate some distractions, I think, is really important in the camp environment. So
You know, for me, reading a good book or having maybe meditating or something that can get your mind off of other things is really important, just so that you can hone in and focus on the training and relaxing and recovering. If you're trying to recreate a camp environment, but you're not able to go somewhere else, and you want to do it at your home, I think some things to really be aware of are, pick those days when you're able to maximize training and go hard, and then on the other days, really focus on that recovery. And you may have to, you know, maybe there's somebody who has a birthday party or a happy hour, and you may, if you're in that real camp mindset, at least when I'm in that camp mindset, I'm not going out to any happy hours, I'm not doing the extracurricular activities. It's solely focused on that recovery and really making sure that I'm ready for those hard days. I'm making those easy days easy so I can make those hard days super hard. So on those big days, I'm eating my normal foods, and I'm also eating a lot of additional scratch products just to make sure that I'm staying on top of my hydration, staying on top of my nutrition. And anyone can do that wherever you are. You just need to make sure that you go into the camp knowing when those hard days are, and just kind of get in that flow and understand that you may need to make some investments into making those hard days hard, which would mean maybe cutting back a little bit on the extracurricular activities.